You might be surprised by the top story on Russia's most popular news program. We were. It's about Canada and its apparent hostility towards Russia. Presenter Olga Skabayeva accuses Canada of fueling the war in Ukraine, which she sarcastically calls an international crisis. She then airs a translated portion of a global news report on Canadian-built armored personnel carriers making a difference in Ukraine. Our report first aired on the new reality without the aggressive rock music or the overt political spin applied by Russia's propaganda machine.
That's a completely torqued view of the truth. And if Russia were to pull out, as it should, a sovereign country can continue to exist. If Ukraine were to stop fighting, Ukraine would cease to exist. And that's the reality.
Roman Shimonov is the CEO of Roshel, which has so far sent over 100 of its Senator vehicles to Ukraine. 8 were bought by Canada, the rest by NATO and European allies. In our story, Shimonov says he'd pop open a bottle of champagne when Putin lost the war. Russia One Skabayeva told her viewers he had a drinking problem.
Because I guess in many Russian minds, the best way to make a person to show him in negative ways to associate him with the alcohol.
The Kremlin controls Russian state TV, using misinformation to further the narrative that its invasion was just. Creating enemies where none exist is a tactic Vladimir Putin has used for decades.
It fits the Kremlin narratives to suggest that Canada is working with these Ukrainian warmongers, Ukrainians who have been identified by Russian state media as being neo-Nazis, Satanists, that they're constantly looking for ways, along with NATO, to attack Russia.
Shimonov says it's important they not lose sight of who created the propaganda in the first place. Mike Drolet, Global News, Toronto.